three, two.
No, you don't say the two and the one.
Oh, my God.
Remember on Wayne's World?
Would you shut up?
That was quick. All right, here we are. Obviously, we haven't done this in a while.
Should we just go, hey, welcome to the show.
Hey, it's stuck in beta time.
We're never going to get out of beta.
I'm Greg, and that's Josh, and that is also Josh.
I'm also Josh.
Yes.
And that's Josh.
And this is our podcast.
He's so bossy.
So,
man, I'm telling you, were you guys able to keep up with all the hate mail after we missed that show last week?
Hey, it was tough.
I'm sorry.
Dude, I mean, it was just, they were flying in left and right. I tried to subdue it as much as I could. It just, they just kept coming.
Yeah. You know, they won a good thing. So I understand, you know, sometimes your favorite show comes on whatever night, Tuesday nights or whatever, and then they go, we interrupt this for presidential speech. You're like, what the?
That's what happened.
And your week is ruined.
Yeah, your week's ruined.
And here we are kind of screwing up again because we're on a Thursday.
Yeah, it just screws me up.
Do we really have a, I'd say regular as long release? As we do it every week, okay. That's regular.
We missed a week.
Well, we didn't miss a week.
But you didn't upload the other show for a week late.
Well, so I did that on purpose.
Oh!
So it wouldn't seem.
Okay. Well,
people
great.
Want more.
Yeah,
here.
Sure. Yeah, you great. Know,
that's a
good
that's
idea.
How it goes. So we were off for a pretty long time. Yeah, you guys do anything? Or did you just sit on your thumbs?
God!
Sat on my thumb.
That's.
Oh, wow.
Oh. Well, my grandpa died. So we had a funeral. Sorry to bring the show down.
Yeah, okay. Sorry. Show's over. Wah, wah.
No, but if you've never witnessed a military funeral with full honor guard and the whole, I don't know, volley or shooting thing, it's something to behold. And the Patriot Guard came up and did the Patriot ride with him. It was pretty cool.
Is there different levels that you can get? Because I know Lori's grandfather got some, you know, the,
was it
the
full military honors?
That,
yeah, that I think it's pretty much the same for everybody. Okay. It's full military honors, and they get the whole flag flying
right.
thing.
Yeah, that's
and
cool.
It was really neat.
Really moving.
I've seen that too.
And then we got shells from the shooting.
Oh
they,
yeah, yeah.
They gave the shells to my uncle, mm-hmm. and he gave all of us a shell. So
did he get buried at?
No, he's buried down here. He didn't. Oh, okay. He didn't want to be buried at JB.
Because that's where my grandpa was buried, and it was kind of the same thing. And me being living next to a cemetery, I've seen some military
have you?
Ones, where they get out there. And
they usually
do a 21 gun, and they usually, there's like three people.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. You know? They use blanks.
Yeah.
It was
yeah, it is
neat.
pretty
it was
moving.
Pretty cool.
Yeah.
But Jackson, it was a whirlwind of a week and a half. Jackson had to go to a birthday party, and it was up at Upper Limits. Have you guys heard about this place?
No, I don't think so.
It's a rock climbing place in St. Louis. It's all indoors, and it's in this, like, probably a three-story building kind of by Union Station off Market Street, and it's nothing but all the walls and ceilings and stuff are covered with plywood and those handhold grips all over the place. It was a pretty cool birthday.
So you place. Climbed, I bet.
No, what? I was the anchor.
Oh, you were the anchor. Okay.
I had to put a harness on, and let me tell you, that's a fun time. And put the rope through.
Go up your crotch.
It did.
Between
it,
the legs.
Yeah, the all the ladies were staring. But no, I was the, you know, I pulled on the rope as the kids went
between
up.
Your crotch?
Yeah, you know, and it accentuates the neighborhood.
It moves things.
People want to check in.
Oh yeah, okay.
I made that saying up. Could you tell?
You did, huh? Yeah.
Interesting.
That's man. That's
it's a neat place. It's worth checking out.
Okay, I'll have to do that.
What'd you do, Greg?
We did a lot of wedding.
I was gonna
stuff.
Say he told me he has wedding a lot stuff. Of wedding update stuff.
Oh,
but I can't really talk about a lot of it
because really?
Some of it is kind of classified until the day.
It's the dance. I bet
well,
he's got
I
it.
Know we got asked for t-shirt
superheroes.
Oh, you don't know about that.
No, okay.
Oh, never mind.
Today I had a request to build a
oh yeah,
a box
yeah.
for their For the card.
Oh, cool. I said I'd help. I can paint.
I'll hold things.
You want me to?
I'll hold nails.
Scalpel.
Yeah. Here. Yeah. Hand me the hammer. You know.
Can you measure this?
I could. Yeah. I can. I'm not useless. Come on.
No. You'll supply the beer.
Yeah. There you go. That's. Yeah. That's all you need. So how many beers did you want to fit in this? No, it's for cards.
Yeah. It's about a 4-beer project.
Yeah.
So you're getting measured for your tux.
Yeah, I'm going to go Monday.
Man, I need to get on that.
You haven't... Shoot, I should have told Jeff while he was here. Yeah, I just got a call from Men's Warehouse.
Saying, get your asshole groomsman in line.
Only gosh, 4 of your guys have been in to be fitted.
How many are there?
Sorry, includes 36.
How you men's?
Let's see, one. I don't know, but there's more than 4. I know that much. There's at least.
So consider
this. I think
this,
there's 10.
Consider this your Stern talking to.
Yeah. Yes.
I gotta get on it.
Get to the mall. Go to Men's Warehouse. It takes 20 minutes.
I know. It's just.
He didn't want people touching his junk.
Well, it's not like the guy on Friends where he moves it to one side to measure.
Moves it over.
Yeah. That's not how they do it.
Oh, that's funny. So you can't talk about anything that you've done over the last couple weeks.
Oh, man. I mean, we got everything in line. Pretty much everything is on schedule. Like,
schedule.
It should be.
Oh yeah, you went to Schlafly. I know
we did go there. That's where the reception is going to take place, and we kind of just we don't really have to pay until like the week before or something. I think he said 11 days or something like that. They just need to know
maybe 2 weeks before.
Well, almost. But we wanted to get another look at it. We had more questions. We found out, so they, I don't know if you remember this, a couple months ago, someone got, there were a few cars, I think, got their broken into or whatever in the lot, and, well, since then, they've upped their security system, they got brand new cameras everywhere, like, they switched, they had a bunch of old black and white ones, now they're all color HD.
Oh, cool.
And they have an armed guard out there all the time.
Oh, wow. Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Like, he's like, he's not wearing a uniform or anything, but he's out there all the time now.
Cool.
So, he's like, he goes, I can guarantee this is really safe now. I guess he had police officers at first, but now they've got their own security.
Cool.
But
good
to hear that.
Josh, you turned 40.
Yeah, so during our hiatus, I had a birthday.
Wow.
Yeah, and surprisingly enough, I was able to...
You had to start Viagra.
I was able to roll out of bed the next morning. I remembered my name. I knew where I was and what my agenda for the day.
Good.
That's nice.
You know, I'm fully expecting all of my vitals to start failing at any moment.
Well, that's 50, right?
I don't know.
Do you wear glasses?
No.
Yeah, I've heard 40, your eyes go to hell like in a week and a half.
One of the cards that I got.
A week and a half?
Yeah. The guy that works for me is like, I turned 40 and I was blind as a bat.
I've heard that too. One of the cards that I got, and I've always had really great vision. One of the cards I got, it was like, so you're 40, and it went down, got small. It was like an eye test. But as you went down, the words got like deliberately blurry.
Oh, jeez.
But, you know, I don't know. I've never had any problems with it, and I don't have any issues. I still feel 39.
Oh, well, that's all that matters.
Yeah.
Actually, I feel better. I mean, we were joking. He, like, the day or a couple days before we had a little party at my house, he sent me a picture of my 30th birthday party, which was a huge surprise party. But I think I feel better now than I did then. I mean, I was, like, not taking care of myself back in my late 20s, and it's much better now than I was then. So hopefully my 40s will be better than my early 30s.
Well, it's funny, I don't feel any different like than I did
mentally even, or physically, or
well, both. Yeah. You know,
well, that's good.
Even like 10 years ago, you know, I don't
I definitely don't feel any different mentally. Or like,
yeah, you know, mentally, I haven't.
I don't think you really know. I think it just goes, and you have no idea.
Yeah.
Well, no. What do you mean? Like
you lose it and you have no idea.
What? I don't understand.
Can you say that again? Where am I? No, I think you're right. Like the same stupid jokes that like we laughed at when we were 18 or whatever. It's still, unless it's my kids that are saying those jokes to me, then I'm like, shut up.
Dumb. You know? It's stupid. It's only good back in Dumb and Dumber.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. So, anyway, yeah. We had a good time, though.
Yeah, it was a good time.
Had a little... It felt like a throwback party, just hanging out and drinking too much beer, and it was fun.
We drank a couple Natural Lights.
Too. Yeah, that's right. That was good.
I haven't done that in a long time.
They weren't bad.
Yeah. It's like drinking water.
They had some flavor.
Yeah, I thought they had a little flavor, which was weird. I'm like, it tastes a little different.
Totally offended by it.
Yeah.
It was good. Yeah, we had fun. And it was so nice out, too. It was like...
And it's nice out today.
Yeah, just like now.
70 degrees in February.
Oh, my gosh. It was great. I don't remember my birth... I mean, this was, the 12th, I think? So it was 2 days before my birthday. But it was like... I don't remember ever, like, around my birthday, it being... nice weather. Yeah. I don't remember that ever in my life, in my 40 years. It's always cold, snowing. I mean, in my elementary school days, I remember it would be like common that we would get off school.
You'd get the day off.
Yeah, it would be snowing or something. I remember even birthday parties would get canceled or postponed because of weather back then. Same for you, I guess, right?
Not really November, Thanksgiving.
Really?
No.
Now his guy.
Yeah, June.
June.
June 25th, man. Perfect.
Pool parties.
The perfect. The ideal birthday. There's nothing that competes with it. There's the weather's usually great. It's 6 months to the day from Christmas.
Yeah. Well, 4th of July is kind of close.
Yeah, I don't think that really ever interfered when you were a kid, though, did it?
No, it just meant I could have fireworks at my birthday party.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, pretty awesome birthday.
But I didn't get the little parade in school, you know? In elementary,
Yeah.
Was, we'll have to do Greg in May or whatever. And, well, I never got that.
No, mine sucked because it was like, it's Valentine's Day. Oh, Josh, it's your birthday?
Yeah.
And it was,
my niece, Jamie, her birthday's on Valentine's Day, too.
Yeah?
Yeah.
My wife does a really great job. She pretty much doesn't care about Valentine's Day, but it's just...
Well, did you guys do anything Valentine's Day for your...
Hallmark holiday.
Hallmark holiday. You watch Hallmark Channel movies, or...
No, it's a made-up holiday.
Oh, you didn't do anything?
No.
Really?
No.
Well, I thought I would do something because women enjoy you to do...
You're not married yet?
Yeah, exactly.
I guess I'm not married yet, but I got her flowers and I made
dinner. We all saw the pictures.
I made some steak.
Yeah.
We made it together. Made some steak and
did it together.
that one thing leads to another.
Steak and...
I got your belly full. Now let's go.
Loaded potatoes. Twice baked potatoes. It's good stuff.
We went out the Friday before, but the actual day of, we just had so much crap going on. But the day before, I guess we kind of hung out a little bit together. We went to go see that movie, Split.
Oh, yeah. How is that?
Do either of you plan on seeing it?
I don't know what it is.
It's that new M. Night Shyamalan.
It's a guy who has split person. What, three?
I've seen it. Yeah, right.
26
26. Oh, they only show like three in the trailers.
Okay,
ruined the movie.
Can I? No, that doesn't ruin anything. All the M. Night Shyamalan movies have a twist at the end.
Yep. So we'll put a spoiler tag on this. So if you want to, if you are planning on seeing.
Okay, we are live again.
The stream's offline, Caleb said. Dad, why are you not wearing the new headphones? Yeah, I got new headphones.
Oh, you got new headphones for your birthday?
Yep.
Yeah, that's nice.
You get those from your kids? Part two.
So anyway, well, tune in 30 seconds from now to skip the spoiler. Go, you have 30 seconds.
30 seconds?
So 30 seconds to talk about it?
Yeah, the spoiler?
You guys don't 2 minutes of spoiler.
There's 15 seconds.
So do you not think that you'll ever see that movie?
I'll probably see it, but maybe.
I kind of almost see this as a movie that Molly would be interested in, but I don't know. I might be completely way off base. So Lori was interested in seeing it because I don't know that she knew that it was an M. Night Shyamalan movie, or she even really
realized.
I didn't
know it was.
I don't know that she even realized that it, you know, what those movies were generally consisted of. You know,
Sixth Sense and Signs.
Yeah, that kind of stuff. So I fully expected there to be something at the end, but I totally missed it. Like, I didn't realize what the what the thing was. Evidently, there's this movie that's a. Apparently, you probably know it. It's a cult classic, I guess, called Unbreakable.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've never seen that movie, I don't think.
Really?
So that's
Bruce Willis and Samuel Jackson.
Yeah, so the movie, you go through the entire movie, and it's like the last couple of seconds or minutes or whatever, that they're like in the, they're seeing like this news report of what happened with the situation with these girls and this guy, the personality. And these ladies are talking at this bar, or at like a counter or whatever, and they're seeing it. News headline, and then they're like, remember that something happened, you know, like so many years ago? What was that guy's name? And then it kind of backs up, and you see Bruce Willis, and he says, Mr. Glass. And it was like,
wow.
So I didn't even catch it because I've never seen that movie. So, like, everybody, oh man, that twist at the end. And I was like, I don't even know what.
So, either does that mean that it's it? Okay, so obviously, this takes place in the same universe or whatever.
Yeah, but it's Philadelphia. Yeah.
Does it also mean there's going to be a second Unbreakable movie?
So I was reading up on that, and then like I don't know that there's any like there's like contradicting reports of like, yeah, he would like to do something like that, but no, he doesn't want to become one of those where it's like sequels. It was just kind of almost like a, I don't know, a tease, I guess.
So
anyway, that's what happened. That was considered the major twist or whatever.
It's not much of a twist. It's just kind of a
well. The other thing,
it's kind of like what you'd see at the end of a Marvel movie.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah, like a teaser.
Yeah.
So the other thing, again, another spoiler. The other thing was that the entire movie, the main character kept speaking in all of his personalities, kept speaking of this beast, and this beast is coming, the beast is coming, you know, all this kind of stuff. Well, towards the end of the movie, he's able to, like, completely, like, I don't know what the right word is, but, like, he was able to, like, he was just small guy, and he was able to, like, change, and, like, they said that this, the doctor said that, you know, these people with their brains could actually change their body makeup. So he was able to, like, this personality, this beast, this like 27th personality was able to like turn into like this Hulk like figure, and then that's whenever he like it got really messed up. Then that was really weird. So I guess that was a twist as well, but it was kind of discussed throughout the entire movie, but I don't know. It seemed like a regular, like it's almost like the Sixth Sense. Like it seemed like a regular, like just your average movie.
Yeah.
And then something, and then weird stuff happened at the end. You know what I mean? So you had to wait through, it was like bore, it was so boring during it.
Really?
Like, I was like, God, where's this going? Like, it just seemed like repetitive.
Huh. See, now one of my favorite M. Night movies is Signs. And
that was good.
I think that is pretty much good consistently through the whole movie.
Who was the main character?
Mel Gibson. And, what's his name?
Not River Phoenix.
Yeah, I was saying River Phoenix too, but it's
Joaquin
Phoenix.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, remember with the aliens?
Yep.
They had all
swing hard or swing hard or swing.
Yeah.
Swing.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah, movie. It's been so long.
Yeah,
all his hits, main hits were
early.
Yeah, and so I was kind of reading up on him, and like I guess over the last few years,
he's had a lot of stinkers.
He tried to transform his from going through big box office movies to like a lower budget. Like that's his thing, is like go low budget type stuff. And I didn't realize that like whenever he did like Sixth Sense and Signs, he was only like 19 or 20 years old.
Really?
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Well, I don't even think
still.
Unbreakable. Wow. I didn't even think that came out on it in the theater.
Oh, really?
I remember only seeing that on video after I saw Sixth Sense.
Yeah, I agree.
It came out in 2000, I think, from what I read. Yeah, he's a different kind of guy.
Yeah.
So, Greg, you have a note about some cool new device?
Oh, well, while we were on movies, I was going to say... Sorry.
No, that's all right.
I was just going to say, I went and saw a very same kind of genre of movie. I saw Lego Batman.
Jackson saw it.
It's freaking amazing. He said it was really good.
Amazing.
What's good about it is if you've ever seen a Batman movie at all, it references pretty much any Batman movie, the Adam West, the George Clooney, you know, everything. But it is hilarious. This movie is very, very funny. And it's, I think adults will get more of a kick out of it than the kids will. I really do, because I don't know if the kids will get all the jokes, but I found it hilarious the whole time.
So when you went to see it, you went like the really late show or something, right? Like the day before?
Molly used to work at Lego, and she's still friends with a bunch of guys that work at Lego. And so we met a bunch of them for dinner, and then we went to the 10:15 showing the night before. And it's funny because there was no kids in the theater. It was all adults. Yeah. In that theater watching it.
So Caleb, my oldest son, he went to go see it, I think the night it came out, and he said that he said the same thing that you just said. It seemed like it was a lot of adult type humor, and it seemed like, I think he said this, it seemed like the kids weren't, the adults were laughing, but maybe the kids didn't quite understand or catch.
I could see that. I mean, did you see the Lego movie?
Yeah,
because Batman's in that too.
Is he?
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know that it's the same. The whole thing straight through.
It's Will Arnett, and I don't know. It's really funny.
My leg's asleep.
Oh my God, Elizabeth! I'm coming to see you.
No, scared me for a second. No, like, oh, crap.
My leg's asleep. It hurts.
He's having a heart attack right here.
God. I got something that'll help that. Let's have some.
It's these stools, isn't it?
It is the damn stools.
You gotta put your feet up.
You know, high. Wedding gifts maybe.
Oh,
bachelor party gifts.
We don't have to do gifts for that.
Hey, why don't we do some gift food?
Is our company.
Why don't we food and drink? Was one of those ones where you put any weight on it, you're gonna go falling to the ground because it hurts. Did I tell you guys I have jury duty again?
No.
Yeah, that's kind of a thing. Don't you get it twice?
I've never gotten it twice.
I've never ever had.
Last time I had it for January and February, and my January one I got, and you know I called up just like you, and it was canceled.
Yeah.
I don't think I got another one though, but I know like 3 years ago had the same thing happen.
I've
never ever been even summoned. Is that the?
You need to vote more.
I do. I vote all the time.
Yeah. Are you registered?
Yeah.
Yeah. Right.
Okay. There's your political comments. You have to throw into things. That's why people hate you on Facebook. Which, by the way, why didn't you take that hiatus?
I did for about a week and a half, and I got sucked
in. I don't think you did.
Oh, whatever.
So, my brother, Jeffrey, he went to...
He called in last time.
Yeah. He went on a European vacation with a couple of my nieces and Chevy my Chase? Sister-in-law. And...
Chevy Chase?
Yeah, yeah.
Beverly Dwayne.
He was telling me about all the beer and all that, and London and Germany and all that. And he went to... Big Ben, Parliament, that's London. So he got me some beer from Germany, and he was telling me like how cheap it was. Like this one he got was 39 cents. Like,
29 cents, I think.
29 cents. This, I think, a four-pack was...
About, two something?
Yeah. So this one, hey, you're... You can probably pronounce that right.
Bayerisch Hell.
Okay, whatever that means. So it's from this. Maybe the company is Monschroff. Yeah. Well,
I wonder if this is like a common beer or if it's a specialty. Because it's got the old, really
the swing style top.
Well, yeah,
there's beers over here that have that.
Yeah, but aren't they this. Generally imports though?
How do we do?
Ooh,
whoa!
It almost got me.
That was awesome. So, I have a feeling this will be kind of it's pretty light.
Yeah, he said hell is not like it doesn't. I guess give any kind of indication of it being like heavy or hard or anything like that. So it means something else.
To man, can't Google that.
That's extremely
it's
light.
Crystal clear.
Yeah. Ooh.
Man. It's a Bavarian beer for you.
Oh, boy. That smells like a skunk's ass. Jeez.
You know, it tastes better than it smells.
It does not taste bad at all.
It's got kind of a sweet.
It's kind of funny, like your senses change immediately. Like you smell it and then you drink it, and it's a complete change in your senses.
Yeah, it's definitely a Bavarian. Uh
oh,
he's hiding this, so this might be.
Well, good. I've got some food to go with it.
Kind of sweet. Chalky or sweet or something. I don't know.
It's, chalky?
I guess.
Let me get another taste here.
I don't get chalky out of this.
Very light, very sweet.
It's not bad. For $2?
Oh, yeah.
For a four-pack of these. And these are big bottles.
My senses are playing havoc. They're like fighting with each other.
4.9%.
The smell is horrible. But the taste is not bad.
The taste is interesting, yeah.
So, sticking with the European kind of...
Oh, is that what we're doing?
I've got some potato chips, but they're Guinness.
Really?
Chips.
Guinness yes. chips?
Yes.
From Ireland?
Well, I don't know.
You got one bag? One little tiny bag?
Do you know how expensive these were?
I mean, thanks for sharing.
Yeah. I was going to eat these in front of you, if that's okay. These are Burt's hand-cooked potato chips with Guinness flavoring. So...
They're going to be extremely crunchy. I bet they're going to be just like crunchers.
Like kettle chips. Yeah. I love kettle chips.
I could see in the ingredients it's got cocoa powder, so...
What?
For Guinness.
Guinness usually have a little... they've got kind of a brownish, the Guinness flavoring on it.
Whoa.
Nah.
Yeah. Kind of more bland than I expected.
Yeah. All I taste is potato chip.
Yeah. Like a salted potato. Yeah. What it tastes like.
I taste a little bit of malt. Like.
Okay. You know,
it tastes a little malty.
Sure you do.
It doesn't taste like Guinness, though.
No, it does not taste like Guinness.
Well, failure here.
Here you go.
Yeah.
Surprised you didn't get us the chocolate covered. Strawberry Oreos.
Why don't you get us the strawberry covered Oreos?
Strawberry covered Oreos?
Yeah.
I didn't go to the store.
Well, we had a couple weeks off.
Well,
yeah.
They're not too.
I wouldn't go out of my way.
They're not terrible.
No, they're not terrible, but
how much were they? You said they were expensive.
$12.
No, I don't remember.
Hi there.
Where'd you find them?
That same place, Lolly and Pops.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
They have a lot of different things there. That's a really cool place.
They probably were expensive than if got them at Lolly and Pops.
I don't know, maybe
six bucks.
How often
are you going to the mall?
No, I got these a couple weeks ago.
No.
Although, a lot more than I'd like to.
That's what we were just saying about going to get measured for the tux. I was like, man, I can't tell you the last time I've been to the mall.
I really try to avoid it at all costs.
So, before I met Molly,
I went to the mall maybe once every 3 years.
Oh, I don't buy that.
You don't buy that?
I think you were you frequented Hot Topic.
Oh, no. No.
Or Spencer's.
No, I didn't go to any of the... So, since Molly, I'm probably there at least once a week, maybe once every other week.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
What? That is... Holy
this
cow.
Is just, this is just wedding preparation stuff, right?
No, she likes going there. Hmm.
That'll change after you get married. Don't worry.
I'll go there more.
No.
What else we got?
What's your wonder device, Greg?
Oh, so this is pretty interesting. No. Apparently, I'm about to get a phone call here. Uh-oh. Sorry.
Hey. Who's calling us?
Hey, no, caller, no, you're on the air.
Oh, who is it?
Oh. Come on.
It's work.
Uh-oh.
Put him on the air.
Yeah, I will dare you.
I will have to call them right back.
Should we take a break?
I don't know. Maybe we should.
All right. Pause it.
Okay. Sorry about this.
Huh?
Is that a thing? We can just pause it?
Hell, I don't know. Take down the microphone.
Just hey, stand by.
Leave the stream going. We'll just take the mic down.
Well, you could talk without me.
Okay,
right?
That's fine. I don't know what Josh and I... Josh, what's Greg's big new gadget that he wanted to talk about?
I don't know. So, have you seen that show on Netflix, that The Ranch? You don't watch Netflix? The Ranch?
What's it about?
It's like a comedy with Ashton Kutcher and...
I like him.
You do like him?
Yeah.
And, the other guy from that 70s show...
The pothead guy? Or?
Yeah.
Okay.
What is it? Danny Masterson?
Yeah.
And they're like brothers, and they live on a ranch with their dad.
Like a dude ranch?
Yeah, like a cattle ranch.
Okay.
And their dad is Elliot, what is his name? The guy with the real rugged voice and drawl. What is his name?
Anyway, keep going.
It's pretty good. It's funny. It's like...
Is it supposed to be a comedy, I guess?
Oh, yeah, for sure. It's like a 30-minute comedy. They'll throw in like some F-bombs here and there.
Oh, really?
I think it must have came out maybe like a year ago. There's like kind of two seasons. They call it like... They don't call it seasons, but they call it like, I don't know, blocks or something, but there's two of them.
Any nudity?
No, nothing like
so
that.
So it might be kind of family-friendly?
Yeah, yeah, but it's funny how like they'll randomly like throw in this... like. F-bomb or something.
Really?
Yeah. It's strange.
Huh. I like Ashton Kutcher.
I do too. And it's just, it's like almost like a old style, well, I guess there's still sitcoms like this, but it's like that three camera, you know, sitcom.
Yeah. Yeah. Wasn't there an article recently that Netflix is trying to revive that three camera setting?
Really?
And I think it had to do with Facts Alive.
Yeah, I could see that.
Because Facts Alive was they had recently redone that. It was a three-camera setting. I haven't watched it. But yeah, they said Netflix is trying to regenerate that genre of show.
I think it's pretty cool. So it's called The Ranch, and the mom and the dad are probably like in their, I don't know, 50s, 60s, and they're divorced and separated. And then like the two sons are... trying to help dad with this ranch, and then their mom owns this bar, and she... It's just like, you know, it just has that, everything's like, you know, not more than a minute goes by, and it's got the, like, I don't know if it's really a live audience, but it's got a laugh track everything with it, so it's that style.
Huh.
And I like it. I laugh at it.
Interesting.
It's pretty funny.
I'll have to check it out.
Yeah, so that, I've been watching that, and it's just like a perfect thing to just watch for like, because I think it's... It's like every episode's like 20,
25 you know, or 27.
Yeah, and there's no commercials. It's
well,
just kind of funny.
I wonder if it was made for TV and Netflix picked it up then.
I don't think so because I don't know. I don't know if they could have gotten away with the link. I think it was made specifically for Netflix. It's a Netflix original.
I've been watching a lot of hockey.
Really?
I don't know why. But this season I've caught almost, I would say, 80% of the games are better on TV.
Really?
Yeah.
Hmm.
I'm there's a game tonight at 7:00.
Into it, huh?
I am, and I've always been a hockey fan. Ever since high school, I've liked the Blues.
I used to try to, but I never really could like stick with it.
Really,
I would get it'd phase in. Like, they're doing not doing well, so I would.
Yeah, they've sucked this year.
But they're doing really well now since they got off coach,
their
right?
five-game winning streak. They swept the road streak, which apparently has never happened in Blues history before. They fired the coach a couple weeks ago. The goalies are got their heads out of their asses and playing good again. We've had three or four shutouts in the last eight games.
Yeah, what is, isn't it something like five goals allowed in the last like six games or something like
three
that?
Three goals in the last five games.
Wow.
Yeah. And That's it
crazy.
Was an average of about 3 to 5 goals a game.
A game, yeah.
And then they fired the coach. Hmm. They fired the goalie coaches. The assistant coach took over. His Hall of Famer, Martin Brodeur, is now the goalie coach. And he's turned these two goalies around. It's amazing what he's done.
Is he a new coach? Like the goalie
Mike
coach?
Yeo. No,
no, I mean, no, the goalie coach. Has he always been with the Blues?
He's
or?
Been with the Blues, but he was director of hockey operations, I think.
Really?
Hmm. Yeah. Martin Brodeur. He played for the New Jersey Devils. He's a Hall of Fame goalie. Won the Stanley Cup a couple times. Outstanding goalie. And when they fired Hitch, they fired his goalie coach.
Oh, okay.
So Brodeur and Jim Corsi, who's another Hall of Fame goalie, took over for goalie coaching. Yeah, so it's been, I don't know who they played tonight, but they beat the Red Wings last night 2-0.
Wow. That's great. Oh, gosh.
He's got Girl Scout cookies on the agenda.
I haven't heard anything about that.
Oh, Girl Scout cookies cereal. Yeah, he posted a picture or something. Mike, our loyal listener, posted a picture. Mike's dog died, so poor Mike.
Sorry, Mike.
That sucks. But Mike posted a picture that he was healing his soul, his sorrow, with a box of Girl Scout cookie cereal. And I don't remember what the flavor was, but then Greg commented and said, oh, yeah, and posted a picture of another flavor of, oh, Mike was, it was Thin Mints Girl Scout cookie cereal. And I don't like Thin Mints.
I don't either. Yeah,
I am not a mint and chocolate person at all.
We're together in that.
But Greg posted some other flavor. I assume he has it. I don't know why we didn't eat that instead of those weird.
Yeah, no kidding.
Those weird chips.
Let's see. So they have a Thin Mints
caramel
and a caramel crunch.
Yep, yeah, that's the one Greg has. Mike had Thin Mints.
Huh. General Mills.
Yeah. Hey, my cousin works for General Mills. I think
the caramel crunch. Oh, it looks like the flavored with. So it looks like the old
Samoas, right?
Is that what that is?
With I think so.
Stripes.
Man, those were good.
Yeah, that's my favorite.
See, that, I like.
That's got the coconut, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like the trifles, the like the sugar cookie ones.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, man,
those
I can go.
Those are okay.
I can go through. Like you give me a cup of milk, a glass of really good cold milk, and a sleeve of those Oreo or those damn Girl Scout cookies. 10 minutes are gone.
What about the peanut butter ones?
I'll eat them, but they're those. Okay. I mean, I like peanut butter and chocolate, but you get
No. I'm talking about the peanut butter in the middle of the two.
Yeah, but it's
there's no chocolate. What are they called? What are they called, Greg? The peanut butter Girl Scout cookies. It's got peanut butter inside and the two halves.
Tagalongs?
No. There's no chocolate.
Yeah.
Those are my favorite.
Oh, yeah. I know what you're talking about. Those are my favorite. Yeah, those are okay.
And
I like those.
And then those there that look like the caramel crunch.
Those are Samoas. Yeah.
That's, so that's, it's funny that you and I have that exact same taste. We hate chocolate and mint together.
Tag along. Do-si-dos.
Do-si-dos. Is the peanut butter ones?
Yeah.
Oh. So we would love that cereal and hate that cereal.
Hey, do you have?
I got the caramel crunch.
Then
why,
really?
Why the hell did we have the chips today? You want me to get that cereal and see how it tastes?
And some milk.
And some milk. No, we'll save it for next week.
No,
if there's some left.
That's funny that they chose the complete, polar opposites of what.
That is funny, yeah.
I saw them both, and Molly was the same way. Probably the Caramel Crunch would be good. I don't know about
the Thin Mints, though, don't you?
I do like Thin Mints. I don't know if that would be a good cereal, though.
Yeah.
Mint cereal, chocolate mint.
The mint and the milk, I think, would turn me.
Oh.
Man, I had a cookie at work. There's always junk to eat at my work, and I was over there this morning having a cup of coffee because I go over there, have a cup of coffee, shoot the breeze with the ladies, and I had a sugar cookie, and I took a bite of it, and it had like peppermint
on it from like a cookie. I'm like, oh my God, where did this come from?
It wasn't part of that cookie?
No!
It rubbed off?
Yes!
We know how you are about mixing things.
Yeah, but it's peppermint on a
mashed
cookie.
Mashed potatoes and turkey.
No, I can do probably mashed potatoes and turkey. Cranberry sauce.
Ugh.
Yeah, that's not cranberry sauce.
That's terrific.
No, it's not.
Oh man, that's funny.
So, is work okay?
Yeah, I don't really want to talk about it.
This brings up a question. I thought this was your job.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, okay. Some other podcaster wanted advice.
See, that's correct.
Yeah.
Yeah,
did you tell him you're in the middle of a show and not to bother you?
Yeah. This beer, it's growing on me and it's not too bad.
I agree.
It's like, a good light beer.
It takes a minute to like this aroma to dissipate. I don't know why would be.
I got a nose issue going on.
It's definitely
okay. For the 12th freaking time, tell us about whatever this new gadget is.
Okay. Cavo. So it's this device. It's basically like a big old switch for HDMI ports. You put like, I think it's got like 15 different ports, like HDMI ports on it.
Holy cow.
You plug it into your TV and you plug in your Apple TV, your Roku, your Chromecast, your Xbox, your all your devices. It knows everything that you it's smart enough to know them all.
A handshake. Okay, so it probably handshakes.
The Cavo, it comes with a remote, but you can also use the Amazon Echo at this time. But you could say, for example, they showed us play Stranger Things, and it'll automatically find it. It'll go like you have a. You have a device that's set as your main device. So say the Apple TV is your main device. It will find it, play it on that. It'll resume wherever you were left off. If you have a DVR hooked to it, like a TiVo, Dish Network, DVR, or whatever, you can look up your DVR playlist. Say, play Big Bang Theory. It'll play your recorded episode of Big Bang. If you unplug that Apple TV and you say play Stranger Things, it'll still know, okay, Apple TV's not here. Let's try it on the Roku. It knows to play it.
Like from the spot that you left off? Or
yes. It is smart enough to know, okay, you want to play Star Wars? Well, you own it on Amazon, so I'm going to play this one.
Okay.
Or you want to play, what's an Amazon show? Man on High Castle. It knows, okay, I can't play this on Apple TV. There's no Amazon stuff. But Amazon Fire, it can play it. Or Roku, it can play it.
How much?
So this is the thing. It kind of seems...
Let us guess.
Okay.
How much do you think?
Is it... What kind of... It's a device? Like,
so it's a device, basically a big, long switch that you plug... I think they said 15, maybe it's 10. You
10 devices.
HDMI ports you can plug in.
Ports you plug
up to that many.
That's a lot of HDMI ports.
And then that plugs into your home system.
Price is Right?
Yeah. Well, wait a minute. And it also... So your remote that comes with it, let me finish.
Come on, Bob, tell us more.
The remote that comes with it is one that you could talk into also.
What? Yeah, that doesn't thrill me.
But it's also, so if you picked up the PlayStation remote and hit power, it would know to just switch to that.
Okay.
And or if you took the Roku remote,
sure,
started using that, it would know to start using the Roku like normal.
Okay.
So anyway, it's like your little concierge service for all your media content, really.
Huh.
It's because it knows, no one system, I don't care, Apple TV has a lot, Chromecast has a lot,
sure,
Roku has a lot, don't have them all, you know?
Okay, so speaking of the Chromecast, though, like... With the Chromecast, you have to cast something to it from your phone, tablet, whatever. Does it know Will it take that place of streaming that from the device?
It knows, yeah.
Wait, no. Does it take the, like, instead of streaming Netflix from your phone, if, oh, Jesus
no,
Christ.
No.
I would guess, if I had to put an MSRP on this thing, I'd say $299.
I'm betting $599.
Okay, are we doing Price is Right rules?
Yeah.
Okay.
You won, just by that question.
You won.
It's cheaper than that.
$399. Oh.
Cheaper than me. Yeah.
$3.99 right now.
Yeah.
And from what they say, it, I mean, watch the video. It's like 15 minutes long. But
is that
they
George Costanza?
No.
These are some. Are these the guys that invented it or something?
Yeah.
Or?
The two on the
left.
Yeah. It's pretty interesting
Bernie
watching.
Sanders on there, too.
Yeah. There's a.
Watching them demo this thing.
Huh.
It's a pretty cool device. The problem is $400 for this thing.
Right.
No way.
Yeah. It needs to get down to
$199, $299.
Yeah.
What is
$100?
$100.
Yeah. What is it that you have? You have the
he's got everything, Josh. Yeah, but you got to narrow it down.
Shoot. Yeah.
I don't have the Roku.
The giant box you have in your living room. What is
TiVo?
That? TiVo. That does something similar where it can find like whether you have it or whether some like
it
Hulu
does.
Has it or Netflix has
it. It doesn't.
How
it
much
doesn't
do you
talk
pay for
to
that?
Plex. I don't pay anything because
no,
I have
you
a lifetime.
It. How much did you pay for it?
Lifetime. I bought the thing for $300,
and that included your lifetime membership.
Yes.
Fee.
So yeah, I was on the money with that price. So this, what does this do different than that does? It hooks to all those other interfaces, I guess.
Yeah, the thing about the TiVo, yeah, you can get into Hulu, you can get into Netflix, you can even get into Plex. But Plex, it doesn't search and see if you actually have it on that. Hulu, Netflix, and I don't think it does Amazon. No, it doesn't do Amazon.
Yours,
the TiVo.
These providers, these content providers, have got to get over themselves and these stupid rules of you can't play Amazon on Chromecast, and they've got to get over
that. They got to start getting along in order to make it easier for the consumer, and then you just take the best device,
right?
You know?
Well, or device preference. It doesn't even have to be best device. I have a preference for Chromecast. Let me play Amazon Prime movies or shows on my Chromecast, damn it.
Yeah.
That's,
and the only way you get around that is by playing it in a Chrome
browser
on a
looks
laptop.
Like crap, and then the not doing it.
But I thought it was pretty it's a pretty cool device. Definitely check out that video. Yeah.
Having 15 HDMI ports on there though, that's something.
Yeah, that is pretty cool.
Yeah, that's noteworthy.
Yeah. Even having that, I mean, think about, for me, I'm one of those who goes, "Oh, I got this new device. I got this new device."
I'm the same way.
It's nice to be able to plug them all in.
You have a Chromecast Ultra already, right?
Yes.
Chromecast Ultra is on sale right now until I think March 5th, $10 off. Anybody out there?
I got the old school one. I've rarely run across any kind of issues 4K. With it.
He doesn't have 4K, though.
You could get a 4K TV.
Oh, gosh.
So I have recently even pared my media down even further. I got rid of Sling.
Did you really?
I have. The only thing I pay for is Netflix.
So over the air?
You know.
Over the air.
And then
Netflix,
your friend's Plex.
This guy I know has got this Plex that just has unbelievable content on it.
So
he's probably going to jail. You know
the
that,
one
right?
thing that was
I hope
cool.
Because I like his content.
The one thing that was cool, I noticed DirecTV Now, I was able to go over to your house.
Yeah, that was
You don't have Sling
cool.
anymore. So I'm like, oh, I'll throw the hockey game up. Boom, boom, boom. It's up on your screen.
Have you heard anything more about Hulu and their providing? Their services
not yet no,
because that was supposed to be coming out soon, wasn't it?
If there were more, like, wasn't Hulu at one time like free?
You could watch like 2 week old shows or something. Wasn't
it was free on the web.
Yeah, like, you couldn't use device.
You couldn't use the app, the apps, or Roku.
Oh,
or
I remember
anything.
That.
Like, why couldn't they like do like that and like just leave the commercials in there, like for a free version?
Yeah, I don't. Hey, you're getting messages.
I wouldn't mind.
Sorry about that.
You talk about that show This Is Us all the time. Like, if I had to watch that show, like if you said, hey, there's this really good show and it's on Hulu and you need to catch up.
So and, I agree with you. It's going to require these content providers, namely network television, to change the way they think about providing content and how they're getting paid.
And it's never, I don't think it's going to change because CBS is coming out with their own. They don't own a share. NBC, Fox, and ABC all own a share of Hulu.
Right.
That's why all their content is there. CBS held out, and they're making their own.
Stupid.
$5 a month for their CBS All Access. Now, if you love CBS shows,
Big Bang Theory,
and the new, they're supposedly they've been talking for a long. There's a new Star Trek series now.
Oh, really?
I'm not a big Star Trek fan, but you know,
yeah.
If I don't, how much I'd watch something new if I owned that service.
Has Hulu said what their service is going to cost? The content service?
No.
I just...
And it's $11 right now?
To me, at this point, Hulu has got to have, I would assume, I don't know, they haven't released it, but Hulu has to have the inside track. If they have ABC, NBC, and Fox lined up and willing to allow their content to be streamed for a fee, Hulu has to have the inside track.
Yeah. If you're able to get the...
If it's under $30 a month.
Right. And I thought they said that it would be.
What would that include, though? Like, for that, just that, like...
That's my thing. Is it just going to include live TV?
Right.
I thought they said it would include their DVR service. Or their... You know, their
it's got to include content. Their recorded it would, content. And would it include $30 with
seems high to me though
without commercials?
I don't know. And again, I come back. That's a great point
because right now I'm paying $11 for the content without commercials.
But Hulu. That's not live content on Hulu.
No, it's not. But the next day,
Jesus, how much are you paying for TV?
$370
My whole thing is
you have Netflix.
Netflix. My whole thing is
I want to be able to talk about it.
Well, and there's something to be said for that. If he would start a business, he could write it off his taxes.
Yeah. Netflix. I cannot count that because I know I would have that even if I had
that.
See, that's even I'm on the fence with Netflix. I could cancel it.
Even if I had cable or satellite, I would still have Netflix.
Yeah.
And Amazon, the same thing. I would still have that because
why?
What? Shipping alone.
I am not a patient person.
I don't do any Amazon stuff.
Yeah, so. Two-day
really?
Shipping.
You don't buy on Amazon?
No. I mean,
my God, it's
literally,
like
I bought three things this week from Amazon. Oh my,
yeah.
And they, you know.
I bought three things this week from anywhere.
I bought a security camera from Amazon. It is freaking awesome.
You showed us that.
Yeah, that's awesome.
You were in your underwear.
See?
And we were watching
right.
it.
That's all right. Where can you find us, Greg? Hurry up.
Apparently, you got to eat. You're hungry.
Actually, I got to go to the bathroom.
You got to poop?
You haven't eaten yet. I thought that was only after you eat.
There's a good schedule. It's on the time clock. It's
Hey,
you could set a train by this, man.
Search for Stuck in Beta on iTunes, Google Play, and Stitcher. Subscribe to us. Check us out, beer30.tv. Also, email us for feedback. I'm slow.
Stuck in beta
podcast@gmail.com.
I think this was a good show.
Yeah.
It was a fantastic show.
First half was me. It's kind of slow.
What?
Kind of slow.
No, first half was good.
Yeah, it was. This whole show was amazing.
Well, yeah, that damn computer. Thing crashed twice. All right, see you next week.
It's not the computer.